Hey, I'm Mr. Beat. In this video, we will look at the principle of comparative advantage and see if the gains of it are worthwhile or not when determining if you want to make a trade. By the end of this video, you will see how economists think about trade. Before we dive into the concept of comparative advantage, let's first look at absolute advantage. Absolute advantage compares the raw outputs per unit of time among producers, companies, or countries. In other words, absolute advantage is how producers of a good compare based on their productivity. Keep in mind that this is a one-on-one comparison among parties for one particular good. Opportunity cost is another way to think about decision-making in production or trade. This is defined as what you have to give up in order to obtain an item. Economists usually view the opportunity cost of a resource as the value of the next best alternative. For example, you are spending time right now watching this video, so that means you can't spend time doing something else. If your next best alternative is browsing the internet, then that means your opportunity cost is the value of pleasure from browsing the internet, which you are giving up right now watching this video. Economists can rank different parties, such as producers, companies, or countries, based on their opportunity cost. The party that has a smaller opportunity cost to produce a good has the comparative advantage to produce that good. This is because the party gives up less of other productions. Let's go through a simple example to better understand these concepts. This table shows the production capabilities of Mike and Jessica per labor hour. For example, Mike is able to produce 7 wings or 1 pizza in an hour. Jessica, on the other hand, can produce 10 wings or 2 pizzas in an hour. We say Jessica has an absolute advantage in the production of both wings and pizza because 10 is greater than 7 and 2 is greater than 1. Recall that for absolute advantage, we are only comparing the capabilities. For comparative advantage, on the other hand, we have to think about opportunity costs. Mike's opportunity cost of producing 1 pizza is 7 wings. In other words, for every pizza that Mike produces, he is giving up producing 7 wings. Similarly, Jessica's opportunity cost for producing 2 pizzas is 10 wings, or you could also say 1 pizza for producing 5 wings. Therefore, Jessica has the comparative advantage for producing pizzas because she only has to give up 5 wings per pizza produced, and Mike has to give up 7 wings per pizza produced. Trade is beneficial to all parties when there are differences of comparative advantage of production. In the previous example, when we allow Jessica to specialize in producing pizzas and Mike to specialize in producing wings, everyone is better off because the total production of both increases. This concept was pioneered by an economist named David Ricardo way back in 1817. Ricardo described gains of free trade using the principle of comparative advantage, which later developed into the Ricardian model of comparative advantage. In summary, comparative advantage is a key tool when trying to figure out what your gains will be in a trade. This works by ranking production parties according to the opportunity cost of production rather than absolute advantage. It is important to note that absolute advantage is a measure of direct efficiency of production, whereas comparative advantage is a measure of relative efficiency. Thus, it can be a common mistake to use absolute advantage instead of comparative advantage when you're trying to figure out what to specialize in. If you want to explore these topics in more depth, come on over to Chegg to watch additional videos, or you can work through some example problems, or you can speak directly with a Chegg subject matter expert.